Hey guys, how's it going? My name's Ndoles, and welcome back to Regrowth. In the last episode, we made these fancy new goggles revealing, which lets us see all of the nodes in the area, and we did some other stuff. I'm trying to remember what else. We made the enrichment chamber, which we're going to use today. We did some work with... I know we did some stuff with Thaumcraft. We did some crucible stuff. We got cinder pearl and the other seeds, shimmer leaf seeds, and we started crossbreeding them to get the taint root, which I have. So I'm gonna break that. I don't necessarily want to pick this guy up because he'll decay pretty quickly. In fact, I'm gonna put that right there. Actually, I want to scan it. That's going to give me stuff and include a new research. Taint root is kind of nasty. It can randomly decay in your inventory, I believe. I think. And it makes a little bit of flux, but not a big deal. But we are working our way. We did some stuff with bees as well. Namely, we made the... where is encoding the world? We made the frames. No, we did that before, didn't we? Oh, no, we needed... Yeah, we made the apiary and then the frames. And then we also did the... we did the centrifuge and completed the What the World Enables? Yes. So we finished that quest line up, which is really good. Really nice. But let's see. We're almost done with Life of the World. We only have a couple more eggs to... create, which we'll do another time. I'm not ready to do that yet, but Tainted Goo and Taint Tendril claim those rewards, and I'm gonna scan. Yeah. Tainted Ghoul. The Tainted Goo dissolves, and the Taint Tendrils dissolve. They're nasty, and they give you Taint, which is essentially poison, I think. I don't think it's wither style effects, but they're nasty stuff. But they are handy. So let's throw the stuff in here. I'll clean that up later. I'm not too worried about it right now. But let's get into what we're gonna do today. So some of the main things we're gonna do, we're gonna work more with Thaumcraft, and then we're gonna get back into Witchery a little bit and do a few things with Witchery. And there's a few other things that I want to do. One of them, as you can see, I have a lot of stuff. One of them we need to do, so, like, to get the probably more quest stuff. So let's come down here and, oh, by the way, I got a chicken. Finally. I got a chicken and replaced this block with glass. Funny story, I put a chicken in there. I actually got another chicken in this little cage. And decided to replace this block with glass, and as I did, it escaped, and then jumped into the container with the other one. I killed those two and broke down the little box from before, and now we just collect stuff. So as long as he stays in there, he'll give me a bunch of stuff, and that is what I want. Because eggs are a little bit of a pain to make, and we're going to want to have a chicken farm over at our farm eventually. So... we need to make these image seeds, which is in a metallurgic effuser where you need compressed diamond or diamond dust, but we can just compress the diamond in the enrichment chamber, and then we'll put that in the metallurgic infuser with the osmium seeds that I've been working with. That is dying just because I'm out of stuff. One of these days I do need to make another coke oven. But I'll get there. Or I just need to, like, let it set for a while. One of the two. Let's put it in here. So once we have the compressed diamond, we can put this in here. And is that not enough? How much does it need? Does it say? I wish it told me how much I needed. So let's go get some more diamonds and compress them. Let's see if it's two diamonds. Will two diamonds work? That is one thing I dislike about mechanism so far, is just with this guy, the recipes aren't quite descriptive enough. I don't know how much diamond I need. It's just something simple to say, hey, you need this many units of diamonds. Okay, that's still not enough. Maybe my book says 5 minutes, so doesn't seem to. So let's just get a handful of diamonds. Let's see if the compressed diamonds are useful for much of anything. It's not that difficult for me to come over here and get a bunch here soon. Once I finish building the farm tower, we're gonna be automating that, and I need to finish building a lot of stuff around here. Wrong side. And yeah, once we finish the farm building, I'm gonna automate it with golems, because that makes sense to me. So hopefully we can get to that soon. We're gonna be doing I'm saying hopefully a lot. We're gonna be doing a lot today if we can get to it all. But let me see uses for this. Yeah, mixed reinforced alloy and refined obsidian dust. Let's get a few more. And I'm just waiting for this. How much does it need? Alright, let's just keep throwing diamonds in here until this little bar goes. Unless... Can it not be, let's see if we can get... If it's the seeds that are doing it. Shouldn't be. I can't imagine why it would be. But... if we break this guy, doesn't really matter. Wait a second, he's already scanned. Never mind, it does matter. Let me see. So it says 10-10-10s or nothing. So let's see if we can get him up to 10-10-10 and then see what happens. It should be really close, so... we'll come back to that at the end of the episode. I'll keep an eye on the farm a little bit while we're doing other things. Real quick, I want to come up here and I want to do something. Namely, I want to grab a book. Where do I keep the books? They're downstairs. Throw that in there, and I'm going to recycle the seed. Because it doesn't seem to be working. I can't imagine that it's going to take like 5 or 6 diamonds to do something with the match seeds. So let's go get a book. Let's enchant a book. And one of the reasons I'm doing a lot with Thaumcraft is I want to kind of prepare for the two boss fights that we're going to be coming up to relatively soon. The main one being the Wither. And then Destruction 3. Yep. Don't know what that does, really. But I don't really want that. We're going to be fighting the Wither and the Dragon relatively soon, hopefully. So we have a lot of researches to look into. Let's just grab all of them. So we have Alchemical Centrifuge, Thaumium Scoop, Talagolems, Excavation Focused, Equal Trade Focus, Umbral Rose, a bunch of stuff. This is the important one, Infusion. Infusion is incredibly important, and that's probably going to unlock some stuff. So let's get some other discoveries, and let's just research all of this stuff. And then we're going to take a look at our Thaumonomicon, because there's a couple things that I want to try to get that's going to make these boss fights in the coming days a lot easier. And we might have just unlocked the research to them because of Infusion. Infusion is kind of amazing. Also, I unlocked this The one focus of Nine Hells, that you get from researching a fire bat in the Nether. So I went to the Nether to recharge my wand because that's a good place for fire, obviously. And yeah, I scanned a fire bat and I scanned a whole bunch of stuff. But let's see, we have a little bit of paper. Most of these wand focuses are not that important to me. Warding is good, but not something I want right now. We're going to want Silverwood Wand Cores. So that unlocked because we've got Infusion. We're going to have to do this at some point. We're not quite ready. It takes a lot of Ordo to make the Runic Matrix, which you need. And then you need a whole bunch of pedestals. Those aren't as bad. And then it's a multi-block structure with arcane stone bricks, which we'll be making some of those today. And the infusion crafting is dangerous. Depending on, more or less, depending on how you do it, it can prove, not really fatal, but it can ruin your day. It's really complicated and a lot can go wrong. To make sure that things don't go wrong, we're going to want a lot of skulls, so that's something I'm going to want to get relatively soon. We've unlocked a lot of tools and just a lot of stuff. The golems, I don't think much with the golems would be unlocked, but one of the things that I want to unlock with this is in here. So there should be... it's still not unlocked. We'll probably need to get the Silverwood wand. So let's do that real quick. So magic. I know I don't do too much of this on camera, but let's do Ordo. I need to get fire, actually. Let's take that back. So Humanus, Cognito, fire. We can shift that to fire pretty easily. And then Arbor has air, but let's go here-ish. And we'll do two of those. And then Herbus, because I have so many Arbors, it's not even funny. So there's Silverwood Wand Cores. Let's take a look now. That will unlock magic staves and crafting scepters, but didn't unlock, not yet, but we're getting there. So we get this, we'll research this. This will give us a little bit of the forbidden knowledge, the warp. So Victus is earth and water. We go fire immediately, and I'm just trying to think what might be the best. So Mortis is good because it will get us to Perdicio, and that'll get us to Perdicio. We can do void, singular air, and we'll do something like this. So that is the blood wand. So we gained a little bit of warp with that. That's not a big deal. 1, 2, 3. I'm just trying to get this. So we need to get that. We can do that. Blood infuse. Oh no, that's not the one I wanted. Uh-oh. Infernal One Core. Oh, it's right there. Alright, let's get some paper. This is one I want, and there is a reason for it. So I'm going to research it real quick, and then at the end of the episode, we'll do our normal thing where we get a bunch of other researches. Do I have... should have a black flower. Let's get some more ink, because we're probably going to need it here in a minute. And I will... We'll get more researchers for me to do off-camera later. But this Infernal One core is something that we're going to want to work towards relatively soon. Instrumentum is Humanus. Cognito. Fire. Then we can do some... Wraths. I have some Telums. I ran out of ink, which is why I made the floral powder. So we can do some Telums, and then should be able to connect them all with fire. Which I have plenty of fire. Cool. So the Infernal Wand cap, core. So again, some warp, because this is a dark magic type thing. But it's going to require Soul Sand, a Blaze Rod, Wither Skull. All these are pretty easy. Pride Shards. Oh, great. We're going to have to beat a boss first before we can do it. But this is going to be more important against the Gaia Guardians. And then Salus Mundus is pretty easy. Balance Shards are not that difficult to make. But the neat thing about this is if you make a wand out of this... One, it will replenish its supply of Ignis, and then in the Nether it will replenish all aspects. But more importantly, it extinguishes you if you're on fire and protects you from withering, as long as it is in your inventory. And then while it's in your hand, you'll be protected completely from all fire damage. So, if you don't know, the... what's his name? The Gaia Guardian inflicts Wither on you. That is kind of the... Honestly, in my opinion, that's more of the challenge than anything else with when trying to fight him, is dealing with the withering effect. That wand completely nullifies it just by having it in your inventory. So that is something we're going to want. With the Wither, it's not going to be as important. But it's definitely going to be good to have. So hopefully this is 10-10-10. No, close though. So let's do some stuff I haven't done on camera for a while. Just because I want those image seeds. I didn't know if I'd have a problem with this stuff if it was already scanned. I didn't think I would. So maybe it does just take really high amounts of stuff. Of diamond, but I can't imagine that. So this is what I do off camera, in case you didn't know. I just kinda go through and scan all these. I do as many as I can, and then I go through them and go, okay, it's got two tens, it's got 10-9-8, that's good. It's 10-9-8 as well. It looks like we're gonna have a 10-8-8 for the last one, and then I put the rest of the seeds in here. Replant. And this should be good enough to get me at least one 10-10-10. And then once I get one 10-10-10, I can easily get more. So we'll let that just kind of set there for a minute. And I want to see if we've unlocked another research that's going to be really important. It should be an artifice. So there is a device somewhere in the Thaumonomicon, which I would like to have. Don't think it's alchemy. No. And thaumaturgy. No. We're going to want this stuff, though, relatively soon. Node stabilizers and that kind of stuff. And node in a jar. Because we're going to want to bring all the stuff to us. All the magical stuff to us. But let's get into some actual crafting and fun stuff. So... I think the first thing I want to do, I want to make, let's continue on with the theme of making magical stuff. One of the first things we're going to want to do is we need to upgrade our wand. This iron cap wand is kind of terrible, and you might think we could jump straight to the silverwood wand, which is what we're going to want. Thaumian Boss Silverwood Wand is by far much better. I don't have the research, but it is... it is very difficult to get without the Greatwood one. I believe you actually need the Greatwood one to get it. So, luckily we have enough magic left in our wand to do that. And then the last thing I'm going to want to do is we need to make 19 pieces of magic fabric. So, let's see how many can we make before we run out of something. We can make like 10 more. So we have 19. That is good enough for right now. Let's see, can we make anything? It's gonna take 5. Yeah, we don't have enough of anything right now, so let's recharge our wand a little bit. Recharging the wand, actually let's charge up the Greatwood wand. Let's not use the iron one anymore. It is obsolete now. We could use it for some basic stuff, but for the most part we're gonna want to use this Greatwood wand now. And I do believe, one, it holds a lot more. Secondly, it will always leave one aspect in a node due to the node preserver research that I have. So there is that. Let's sleep, and then we're going to walk over to the Nether for a minute and get a little bit more aspects. What I want to do is get to the point where I can... Nether is not that way. Is get to the point where I can make the thaumaturges, robes, and all that fun stuff. And then we can make a few more interesting things. That's going to be super useful in the future that we're not going to really get into using yet. But like I said, at some point we will need it. So might as well go ahead and make it. There's a node right there. So let's grab that. And then we'll head into the Nether and see what kind of nodes we can find. So this one looks like air and... oh, just water. We're full on water, so that's interesting. There's another node over there. I could bring up the heads-up display and go to the ones I want, but I don't want to go too far. I shouldn't need to. This has some air and Perdido. That's good enough for me. And you can fully deplete a node with the node preserver. You just have to hold shift. But let's... there's a couple nodes. There's right here. There's one that has fire, and I think another one has air, which was something I was lacking. That spider got really close. So we gotta kill this stuff. Alright. Hopefully he'll leave me alone. Let's get the fire. Okay. I just need to. There we go. Stupid ghast. Oh my god, there's another one. Alright, so this guy needs to die. Tongue of Dog, that's good. Air and Perdido, that's... so all we're missing is Terra and Ordo. And I'm trying to think if there's any other nodes around that I could get that from. There's some creepers there. Kind of want to stay away from that. I don't see any. Let's look over here for a minute. Most of the nodes in the Nether are going to be fire. Which is alright. Like, it's understandable. Eventually, once we get flight, there's going to be a lot of nodes around the lava. I don't know why. I think it's just because there's a lot of wolf in air and they can spawn, but... it's not something that we're necessarily going to want to do much with, but, I mean, they're going to be there. So, let's actually bring up the heads-up display. We need, Ordo, more than anything, and Terra. There is a pure Terra that's pretty far away. Let's look at Terra. There's one. Yeah, that's even farther away. Alright, so do we need much Terra? We do. So I guess we're going to have to go over there. It's not that far away, so it's not a big deal. But we'll recharge our wand, and then we should be able to go ahead and make the Thaumaturge's robes. And that is going to give us a discount for all of the... yeah, there's two nodes right here. There's a lot in the ocean as well. Does this have... It has Ordo. And then this is the one that has Pure Terra. It's actually a really nice node. Alright, and... I'm trying to think. So... need one of each. We're going to need five more. I'd like a little bit more Ordo. So it looks like this way. There is an Ordo node. And yeah, so eventually we'll have all of the nodes we could want at our base. So I won't have to do this. Well, honestly, if I can get the nodes that I want, and there are some bees that if we ever get to that point, they can help the nodes, I believe, then we won't have to worry about doing what I'm doing right now. It'll be all at our base, it'll be nice and orderly and neat, and everything will be perfect. But for now, we have to go out in the world and find nodes. Honestly, some of them, it might be best to just kind of, like, get the, just go searching. Because nodes do give you research aspects, or, like, research points. I believe it's a tenth of whatever they have, or like, a sixth, or something like that. It's a fraction of what they have. So, the Terra node that was up to, like, 40, I wouldn't get 40 Terra points for researching that. I would get, like, 4. So, it's not that good, but it's not bad either. It's a decent way to get research points. But anyways, let's come back. Let's get all of this stuff. And hopefully I can remember what all I need to make. I think I do for the most part. Let's get rid of this stuff. And let's finish up making the... was it magic fabric? Enchanted fabric. Actually, let's go ahead and make our first piece of armor. Would it be better to do 7? Nope, doesn't matter. And we'll make the boots. And if we put this on, and then make the last one, it'll be a little bit cheaper. So, not much more, but it's a little bit. So there is full Thaumaturge's gear. Doesn't look too bad. I kind of like it, actually. It's nice. Now, I believe that was a quest, so let's take a look. Yes, actually, we have two quests completed. Oh, because we made the Great Wood one, so that's going to give us two aura nodes to place whenever we want. And then the magic fabric, the Thaumaturge's robes, give us that. Okay, that is a warp effect. That just gave me a research point for air. That's really nice. I'm going to keep the nodes in here because I don't want to use them yet. We'll open those later. But we need to make... So, an arcane alembic and a alchemical furnace. Now, to do this, we're going to need... One, we're going to need a cauldron because we need to make another crucible. So, just set that down. Make the crucible. And I need to eat before we do too much more. I should probably go check my plants after this and deal with that kind of stuff. But we're going to make some arcane stone blocks, which are just stone surrounded by a shard of some sort. It doesn't matter. I think... Actually, does it matter? No, it doesn't matter at all. So 9 arcane stone blocks. You get an extra one for some reason. I don't actually know why, but we can make the alchemical furnace, like this, takes a little bit of essence, or this, but V, but we have it, so not a big deal. And then the next thing we're going to want some silverwood planks, and we need two, actually, no, we're going to need a V filter. So that is how you make those. It's silverwood planks with a little bit of gold. And what we're going to be doing is we need to make arcane alembics. So how this works is the alchemical furnace, you place it down and you cook whatever items you want in it. And then what happens is the raw essence from those items, so like iron would give you metallum, buckets would give you metallum and void. The raw essence would be filtered upward into the arcane alembics. Typically you want to have two or three of these. The quest only wants one. I'm going to make two for now. I'll probably make a third when we start getting into this kind of stuff. But it's just the V filters, a little bit of gold, some iron, and buckets. So it's pretty cheap, honestly. And there we go. So I'm going to take the wand. Let's turn that quest in. We need a warded jar now. Alright, so let's look up how to make that. Because I don't actually remember. It's not that difficult. Oops. Alright, so it's a slab and some glass panes. So do I have that? I do. I'm going to want to make quite a bit of these later, but for right now, one will be enough to get the quest, I think. The quest only wanted one, and they're going to give me 16. I don't remember how many essences there are, but you're going to want basically one for each. Although, not really. You don't need one for each, but it's nice to have. And that unlocked a lot of stuff. So, alchemical construct, essentia tubes. Well, I have the essentia tube, it just gave me that. So I just need to make two alchemical constructs. This lets you make automatic crucible furnaces, meltdown. So fluids, okay. So it lets you basically melt down fluids into stuff, and then we're gonna need a lot of stuff for infusion. So we're gonna stop there with Thaumcraft, I think, for now. We'll come back to Thaumcraft later. But before we do too much else, I want to make another item that is going to be fairly useful. So if we look right here, do stone slabs, and I believe it's just some iron. So stone slabs and then two iron makes an armor stand. These are really nice. I'm going to put one right here for the time being. And as you can probably tell, what it's going to let me do is exactly what the armor stands in vanilla do. I need a stick. It does require you to do like a redstone signal. But other than that, it works basically. Actually, I don't know how the vanilla ones work. But if you have a redstone signal, you shift click. You change armor with whatever it is, so I can put my elementium armor back on, and then I can come over here, shift click, do my magic with this, get the discounts and all that fun stuff, and then change it when I'm done. So yeah, that is just a convenience item for myself. Wasn't too difficult to craft, so it wasn't a big deal. Let's go get some food. Let's get some food cooking up, because I am out of... Actually, I have plenty of wheat here, so I'm not going to go up, but I do need to take a look at how everything is doing in here. Perfect. So let's get these guys crossbred. Hopefully that'll be quick. We've got some witchery stuff that I want to do, and actually I want to do one of them pretty much right now. So let's get some food cooking up, and then we'll... I'm stuck. Then we'll go ahead and get the witchery stuff that I need. So one of the first things we're going to be doing with Witchery is we're going to be mutating some stuff. Now we've been able to do this for quite a while, and before we do that, let's open all these. Wow, a lot of stuff. Ooh, that's actually really nice. So let's kind of clear out our inventory now. Gold coins, some armor, throw that in there. Perdita ring, I believe those lower the cost of the elements themselves. So actually just throw these in here. Some of those are really bad. And let's go upstairs. So what we're going to be doing with Witchery is we need to mutate some stuff. We have had access to an item called the Mutating Sprig for quite a while, and we made it. It was a quest a long time ago, but there's a couple other quests that the book wants us to do that's going to be very useful in the near future, that we need to take care of, just so that we can get more stuff. And get farther in Witchery. So that is what all of this stuff is for. But before we can do anything, we have to go to our mana pool. And that, by the way, is why I set this up. I did that between episodes. I just threw some dirt down. And there's a block of water in between because that's what we need. So first thing we need for this one that we have to do at night because I don't want things to die is mana infused string, which as you just saw was mana in the string in the mana pool, and then a piece of cobweb is made from that and four string. Not too difficult. We want to do that. We'll hit this. Now we need to get four alder saplings on each side, and then in the cobweb, we need to trap a zombie. And now while this is working, we just hit the web and we get critter snares. So that is how you mutate things. And alright, I can just break them. That is good to know. So we need to get critter snares. Quest is going to give us four more. These are very useful to mutate other things. And then the other thing we're going to need is graspers. Now this is a lot easier, and is what the other stuff was for. Which I already had in my inventory. Dirt. So we just need to, rather than a cobweb above the water, we need long grass. That will work. And a chest of... We need a chest above. No. I have to put something down, don't I? Chest, and then we need more long grass. Awesome. So I'm going to get rid of the flowers because I don't need them. And again, all we have to do is hit this, and we get these graspers. So these guys hold items, while the snares hold basically creatures, usually a bat, silverfish, or slimes. So that's going to give us four more graspers, which is good. And that's going to unlock a couple different things. So that's going to unlock... Okay, I really need this rain to stop, because it's really loud and annoying. So let's come upstairs and stop it. So yeah, now this is going to let us mutate things we can find in the world to get things we can't find that fits the Witchery theme. So, Parliament presiding. So, owls. That is what we're going to be... That's what we need from this. So we need 2 to 4 ensnared bats and a wolf. You place a spider's web above a block of water. Place the ensnared bats on the sides of the web. Then place 4 graspers at the corners of the square and place 3 charged stones. Place a charged stone in 3 mutandis extremis. Wolf gets caught in the web. Right click with the web to get owls. And then the other one is frogs. So you need 2 to 4 slimes on an ocelot. And then it's basically the same thing. Yeah, it's the exact same thing. Now the reason you need these are in Witchery you can have a familiar. There are three familiars. You can have you can have cats, owls, or frogs. Each one does different things. They'll teach you different curses and stuff like that, depending on which one you choose. I believe cats is... owls is flying. Cats are... I want to say curses, and then toads are brews, I believe. I don't remember exactly, but they are very useful. We're not going to get into that today, though. I do wonder if that opened up anything else. But we need to make something else that's going to take a little bit of time. So let's look into our bag of all this. We're almost done with what I wanted to do, so that's good. So we looked at this last time, and I decided not to go forward because it was going to take a while. And that's because we need to make redstone soup. Sounds easy. So redstone soup requires all of this stuff, which is easy to get. The tongue of dog is probably the hardest to get, but it's not that bad. But then we need the drop of luck. Drop of luck is not terrible, except for this refined evil, which requires diamond vapor, which requires oil of vitriol, which I think I have. I do. Alright, so let's get that distilling. Right here. So oil of vitriol and a diamond will get us, that'll do its thing, and it will get us the diamond vapor. Now the other thing that we're gonna need is this drop of luck, which, okay, we might have an issue with this. We might not actually have enough power. We should with the white circle, hopefully. I don't know how much it reduces the cost of stuff by, but if we look at, is it brews? Yeah, I think it's this one. Yeah, drop of luck. So it requires 5,000. Okay, we should actually have enough. That shouldn't be bad. That shouldn't be a problem. But in order to make the drop of luck, we're going to need netherwort, mandrake root. So let's grab that. We need another mandrake root. We need netherwort. And we're going to need Tear of the Goddess and Mutanus Extremis. So most of those aren't that bad. But it's the actual Refined Evil and Drop of Luck the Drop of Luck that's annoying. In this mod pack, it's a little bit easier to get the Refined Evil, just because the Gas Essence really, really helps with that. So we have Diamond Vapor now. I think we're going to need one of those. So Tear of the Goddess. No, we're going to need it for the Refined Evil, which is just gas tier and Diamond Vapor. Although Diamond Vapor is one of the things we need for this quest. So I want to make sure it knows about it. We're not going to be doing that quest anytime soon. I do not want to summon Leonard. He is scary. But then we're going to need Mutandis Extremis. What else was it? Tear of the Goddess, which is Breath of Goddess and Lapis. Which I have Breath of the Goddess. And let's go ahead and get... Once this is done, we should be fairly close. So this will make all that stuff. Particularly the Refined Evil is what I want. Reconfortune, Fortune, we can just throw all those in there. So the order is Mandrake, Nether, Tear, Refined Evil. Alright. As long as we get the tier of the goddess, we can do this. Let's get a bucket of water. Actually, three buckets. And our altar power is at 4140. So it should be enough to do this. But we could also just go grab some bone meal and make it a little bit more grassy. There's a spider in my base, isn't there? Alright, where did the spider spawn? Right there. Should have known. Alright, so let's get a little bit of bone meal while we're over here. We'll also go ahead and get the... actually, one will be enough. We'll go ahead and get the... we'll check on the why am I blanking? The osmium seeds. So, yeah. Refined evil is just terrifying to me. Not refined evil, the drop of luck is terrifying to me, just because there is a good chance that it will not work and I will lose all this stuff. Luckily, it's not that bad to get, but you do need a lot of altar power in order to do this. So let's make it grassy over here. And I wasted those. Oh well. Made it a little bit better. But let's grab Tear of the Goddess and hope for the best. So the white circle should prevent any bad effects. So let's throw this, 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 this. It seems to be working. It does take a minute. Does it not have enough altar power? Alright, I need to boost the altar power a little bit. I'm trying to think what else might be good. Let's just get some more bone meal. Actually, let's get some flowers. And just try to boost the power like this. Alright, so it doesn't seem to be working. I put everything in correct order. It just takes 5,000. What else? We can put some saplings down where they... Is that reaching? 4,828. No. But let's do something like this. Actually, let's... do something like this. That worked. But it seems to not want to... Okay, 32. I don't know that I want to use that, so let's... I'm trying to think what else could be... Spanish moss. Let's grow some more. That worked. That did. Can we put some more... wood? 68. No. Did the one work? No. Okay, so let's get some more... I'm trying to think what else... I wish I could remember what else helps. It's basically anything that's organic. I know oak saplings would work. More trees, more leaves, that kind of stuff. Let's do something like this. 45. still working, so let's keep going. Let's actually grow one of these trees. I really need to keep bone meal, like, nearby. Actually, let's get 1, 2, 3. And we can grow some of these trees. Like I've said before, I will clean up the witchery area a little bit more. I don't remember if the altar can go through walls. If it can, so that should be a big boost. That was a little bit of one. Put these around. Okay, I think we've hit the max on those. You know what? Let's grow. Ow. Let's grow a witchery tree somewhere. Let's grow it like here. This might be out of range. I don't know. Hopefully this. Nope, didn't grow. Let's get some more bone meal. This witchery stuff is. I'm just trying to get enough power to make this redstone soup. If I can make one, then I can make more later. And that is basically all I'll need to do is just make a little bit more later. Because I'm going to want to fill the chalice with that. It will further boost the different stuff. So let's get Rowan sapling. Or two. I don't want them that close to the fire, but over here-ish. That's alder. Let's see if one of these will grow, like, here. There we go. So how's that? There we go. So I'll probably have to redo this brew. Let's see, do I have Breath of the Goddess? I'll need to go get more lapis. I'm gonna keep some bone meal over here for right now. So we just need to get all that stuff again. Luckily some of it wasn't too bad. Let's get the lapis. We're gonna need a ghast tier again, which I have plenty of. Lapis. Alright, and we'll just restart this. So in the distillery, we already have the diamond vapor, so that's one thing we don't have to worry about. Diamond vapor, that. Let that go. I'm trying to remember. You can throw wood ash in the cauldron to clear its inventory, so let's do that. Right? No, it's quicklime. It explodes to clear the inventory. Doesn't really do anything. But let's throw this stuff in here. Slime ball. Alright. Do we have refined evil yet? Almost. So, refined evil, mutantis extremis, netherwart, and mandrake root. So I'll have to go grab those. Let's put these in here. One of these days I'll come over here and just do a lot of... I need to get my tree farm a little bit better. Just so that I can get all of the different things that I need. All the different saplings and whatnot. So here, and then mandrake root, netherwort. Netherwort, mandrake root. Alright, so this time it should work because I should have enough altar power. Let's do that. And we come back to that while after we do the redstone soup. I do know that this episode has been going on for quite a bit. We're almost ready to finish up, so it's not going to be too much longer, but I mean, sometimes just doing things, it takes a little while to work. But we should have everything we need. Alright, mandrake root. And then the last thing was mutandis extremis. So let's try this again. Let's get the bucket of water. No, this one. Here soon, since we have infusion, we might be able to research something that's going to make my life a lot easier with this stuff. So, mandrake root, nether wart, tear the goddess, find evil, mutandis extremis. So we should see... why isn't this working? Witch's Cauldron, yeah, this is what I'm using. Okay, so I'm doing something wrong, and I don't know what. Maybe I don't have enough altar power still. I'll have to look into that. We will do the redstone soup next time. I'm not going to waste time trying it again for a third time, so I'll figure out what is going on with that. So let's put this stuff back. And I will... Yeah, get back to that. So let's go see if we have a Tintintin osmium seed. Hopefully we do. We should. Honestly, by now. So is this guy Tintintin? If he is, I'm going to go ahead and take him. Yep, it is. Awesome. So let's get the image seeds. And that should unlock some more stuff. And then we'll go through the Thaumonomicon, get some research stuff. And go from there. So let's get plenty of research. And then I also need to grab this. Alright, so there should be hopefully there's enough diamond in here. I can't imagine that there's not. Oh yeah, there we go. So while it is doing its thing, let's get Nona Jar. Let's get warding, portable hole. Those are nice. Thaumium wand caps. We'll want to have that for the Silverwood wand. Alchemy. This is a quest. There's also a boiler, I believe. I don't know if that's something we've seen yet. It might be, but I don't know. Don't really want any of this yet, so let's keep going down. Eventually I will get that stuff. Don't need that right now. Crafting. So I already have the alchemical boiler. That's good. Let's see, we will want the... Nothing in there. But in Silverwood Golems, okay, we'll research that. Sticky jars, don't want that. Oracore, okay. We'll take a look at that. I have no idea what that is, so. This guy, Thaumium Esoteria? No. But is it under Witching Gadgets? There is something that I want, and I'm not seeing it. I thought... Does this even have it? Yeah. Stomach exploration. Which... Isn't that... This is... So, red crystal... is automagy. Alright, I can get rid of all this stuff. I was going to plan to do a little bit of the, ME stuff. Start getting prepared with that, but I think we'll do that another time. Let me look up at Thaumic exploration. So, okay, it's got the think tank. It's this one. All right. So why am I not seeing it? Let's just research stuff in here. Floating candles. Why not? So I've got everything in here. So I'm evidently missing something. I'm just trying to think what. We want that. Alchemy? Maybe it's something with alchemy. Do I not have any more paper? I don't have any more paper. So that's where we'll stop with that. I will do some of those. Yeah, that's what I thought. So we have the image seeds now. That is going to give us some stuff. Cool. And then that's going to unlock some more quests. So we'll get into those another time. How the world bleeds. We need to do blood magic still. We need to do some more witchery stuff. Thaumcraft is going well. I just need to figure out how to do the drop of luck. That thing is bugging me. We can make more stuff. Coding the world. Still have to do the beehive. And I'm just looking. This has blood magic stuff that we can't do yet. Again, we need to do Gaia Guardian stuff. Alright, so I think in the next episode, we're going to get a little bit more into witchery. Do a little bit more with that. And then I think we're either going to do an ME system or we might look into actually fighting the Wither and dealing with that. So, yeah, that will be fun. Because we need a beacon. And I didn't see the last thing I wanted with... the item that I want before we go fight the Ender Dragon, which is a it's a harness. What is it called? Thaumostatic harness. So that is something that will let us fly, and I don't need to fly it that much, but it will be nice. We're gonna make a nice bow, a crossbow next time. So I will look into what's going to be the best materials for that. Because I'm going to want to get a really powerful bow that shoots fast and shoots hard. And once I figure out what we'll use, we'll make it and go from there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I really need to figure out what is going on with this. Whether it's just not enough altar power or what... I don't know why. I've got a lot of altar power. Let's clear the inventory. I will figure that out. I'll do some stuff with witchery. And that needs to stop. So I'll probably finally clean up witchery between episodes and yeah, figure out what I was doing wrong. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye!